Okay, so first patient is the patient in which we had a young lady, and she presented with a pancreatic head mass, and we saw that it was encasing the portal vein and also the vessels. Okay, and now ma'am is going to elaborate about the FNAC of that lesion.
The FNAC was done, the cellularity was very good. And though we were expecting a neoplasm, but what we got was these large granulomas. These are the granulomas which you can see. There are epitheloid cells with lot of lymphoid cells around it. And then few of the giant cells were also noted around these granulomas. So this is a typical case of granulomatous inflammation, and in a setting of India, the first possibility is possibly tuberculosis.
So Anand was right.
Because necrotic material was also there, so the first possibility is tuberculosis.
So about the next patient, this is a patient from Iraq who had a DOTA positive duodenal pre-caval lymph node, but the duodenal biopsies came out negative. We repeated it multiple times. So we repeated FNA from the lymph nodes, and ma'am would elaborate on that.
The FNAC was done from the lymph nodes, and this is the smear of those lymph nodes, highly cellular. And we can see there are these clusters of cells, and tight clusters and some loose clusters which are there. The background is showing some lymphoid tissue. And we can see here that the cells are very uniform, and some Meissner pattern is there, which is very classical for a neuroendocrine tumor. Thank you.
You can please start the lecture of Dr. Conley Lee, and in the meantime we will get ready. Doctor, are we ready with the pseudocyst? Not yet.
Okay. Hello everyone.
So Dr. Conley Lee, lecture please.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Chen Lee from Shanghai. Today my topic is some microscopy and two nodes, how far can we go? With the development of the endoscopic diagnosis, a lot of cases such as early cancer, and also including some microsalations has been detected. What can endoscopists do in the area of MIS? So the endoscopic resection technique has also development. We can use EMR for easy cases, just like polyp or other small lesions. We also can use ESD to even as endoscopic for cyclic resection for removing and some lesions. We also can use endoscopy can also go outside the GI lumen to resect it some lesions such as in the abdomen or in the medial stadium. So we call it two nodes. I will show you a video with the endoscopy for cyclic resection for the treatment resect. This is the last video. So you can see then we enter the abdominal, then we found the gallbladder. This is gallbladder fundus. Then we cut the gallbladder fundus. the scope can enter the scope ladder. This is scope ladder. You can see a lot of stone. Then we just then we. Take it using after all the stone has been take off, we close it using metal clip, or you can also use an overstitch for closure the scope ladder. Then we check.
You will have to go because the patient is intubated.
So okay, sorry. How? Okay. So this is stone. So the last slide, this is submucosal endoscopy and the EFTR makes the transluminal procedure, just neck nodes, two nodes possible, such as for treatment of extraluminal lesions. The future of flexural endoscopy is not only operating in the natural orifice, but also within or outside the GI lumen. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
So we are coming toward the last session of the day, towards the last few cases of the day. So we have one, your colleague is tired, so you have to go up. He says, I want you to do, there is a duodenal lipoma. So he is. So everybody has backed out because nobody except him.
Okay.
So he's willing to do a duodenal lipoma. The patient wants the tumor out. So that is the case we have. And but we have another cystogastrostomy and a rectal ultrasound. So so we are, hopefully we will be within time. And Dr. Rajesh Puri, you are on.
Yeah, so somebody will tell the history of the patient? Okay. So if you look at the CT scan of this patient, and patient was referred for the EUS guided pancreatic cyst drainage. And we are using the linear echo endoscope. And at this moment of the time, I am in the first part of the duodenum. What I generally do, like we are discussing in this the entirely about the management part, so I'm not going to discuss the anatomy part. When I took my scope into the first part of the duodenum, and doing the clockwise, anti-clockwise movement, can you see a cystic structure here?
Yes.
So can we focus the CT image? Have somebody has shown the CT image in this patient? Can somebody focus on the CT image? Yeah, can you see the CT films? Can you enlarge it? Can you go a little bit more nearby that? You see a large pseudocyst?
Yes, we can see.
And seen in the head of the pancreas?
Yes.
With a well-defined wall. So as this patient has a recurrent pancreatitis, but while doing with the linear echo endoscope, what we have observed, if you look at the cyst here, can you see the cyst cavity here?
Yes, a thick walled and...
Yeah, it's a thick wall. If you look at the duodenum, it appears to be thick. Can you see the duodenal wall is thick?
Quite thick.
Now, few important observation. Can you see here some hyperechoic areas? Can you observe here hyperechoic area?
Yes.
And if you look at this cyst very carefully, if you look at this cyst carefully, which has a hypoechoic content, iso to hyperechoic content, and the few hyperechoic specks. So the and the cyst wall is not well defined. That indicate there is a possibility these hyperechoic contents are the air specks.
Infected.
And the cyst is not as big as shown in the CT scan. And the contents are heteroechoic, so the possibility that this cyst has given away into the duodenum. And when we look endoscopically, we see the... If you see here...
Can you see the endoscopic view? Because right now the
endoscopic
view is...
Can you see something is popping from the inside? Can you see?
Yes, we can appreciate.
Yeah, can you see here?
Something coming out.
Yes. And the same thing has happened in this case. while rotating clockwise and anti-clockwise, I am rotating. Can you observe here?
Yes.
So there's swelling in the bulb of duodenum, there's inflammatory reaction, spontaneous bleeding, there was signs of gravity inside of that lesion, so there's air inside and there has been spontaneous rupture from the duodenal bulb into that cyst. So it's a typical natural behavior that was the first pseudocyst published in New England Journal of Medicine. It has shown us on how that pseudocysts are draining spontaneously.
So Rajesh, what is your plan?
Nothing.
So the plan in this case, because it already has given away into the duodenum and cyst has decompressed. So now what I am going to do in my clinical practice, I will look at the patient. If the patient is symptomatic, if he is running fever, then I might put a guide wire from the duodenal side and will wide open it, and that will act as a drainage. And if the patient is asymptomatic, then you just leave it, and with the passage of the time, the cyst is going to drain through the duodenum opening.
But that may not be sufficient enough, large enough, in due course of time it may heal.
So this will depend upon the patient's symptoms. If patient symptoms, what happened is a patient who has a large pseudocyst, and he came to your OPD with the severe pain abdomen, and you repeat an imaging, you see that the size of the cyst has reduced because it gave away either in the duodenum or into the colon. In this case, if I find that patient is symptomatic, he is running fever, he has leukocytosis, then either I will try to go through the same opening which has made in the duodenum, the nature has made the opening. Otherwise, if I find that is not feasible, then I will try to do with the help of endoscopic ultrasound. But here, can you see the duodenal wall and the cavity is going towards the duodenal wall? Can you observe here? So there's a possibility if I put an endoscope or the side wing scope, I can puncture with the cannula and I can go inside the cavity, I can aspirate it and dilate the same opening. And if the patient is symptomatic and the EUS condition permit to drain this, then you can do a EUS guided pseudocyst drainage. But in this case, I feel so that I think we should wait. The walls are saggy, you can see the air specks. Can you visualize the air specks here?
Yes, the white dot.
And on endoscopically, we can see the dirty material is draining out of it.
Yeah. So, we should recommend the patient to move and to go and that he might change his position so that the natural orifice will keep open. That might be a recommendation for him after sedation.
Yes. And second important thing, if patient has a chronic pancreatitis, in this case patient is not having a chronic pancreatitis. If patient has a chronic pancreatitis, I might do the pancreatic intervention to look at what make this, does this patient has a stones or does this patient has a stricture, so you can correct it. And meanwhile, because the size of the cyst has reduced, so
but
that can help.
The of the cysts are very thick and echogenic, so you think it will drain by itself?
Yeah, most likely my feeling it will go, or I can do the single time aspiration. Doing the complete pseudocyst drainage in this situation with the thickened wall, I think is not advisable, because the total content volume I don't think is not more than 40 to 50 ml or so.
Or even less.
So it is better to leave it, wait for the patient. If the patient is symptomatic, try to see the opening which has nature has made into the duodenum, or I might do the single time aspiration if required.
So we have those two options. In the septic patients, we need to do something. But
yes.
He is not septic. And for a major cyst, which has a natural orifice in the duodenum, which we can nicely depict also on an endoscopic view, there's nothing to drain.
And when will you call him back, and with what antibiotics?
So the antibiotics, if the patient is asymptomatic, if he is not running fever, I think we can wait. And if the patient is symptomatic, then you have to take out the pus. You can take the content for culture sensitivity and you can start. Otherwise, in our day-to-day practice, when we give the cefaparazone sulbactam, that is Magnex, and we give for 5 to 7 days and we follow the patients. But if the patient has a chronic pancreatitis, I think this patient require may not be in the same setting, maybe after some time to look at the pancreatic duct to correct the pancreatic pathology. If there is
totally
a stone, you have to remove it,
yeah.
Or you do a stricture, handling the stricture, so patient should not have a second episode. But my feeling is we should leave it. If somebody want, then we can aspirate it one time and we can completely drain it. What is your opinion? Should we do a single time aspiration or
there's
should we leave
no
it?
There's no need, and since it has always a little bit of risk and bleeding and whatever, there's no no need and no benefit for the patient.
I agree
so
with
if
you.
There is no benefit.
I had a query.
Hmm?
Sir, the lumen, the opening to the duodenum is not big enough and the cyst has not completely collapsed.
Yes.
So being in continuity with the GI tract, the possibility of it becoming an abscess is much more. And right now you can see the orifice, so why don't dilate it and...
Yeah, so two things as I said. Number one, we are not sure when this cyst has ruptured. There is a possibility that when the CT scan was done in this gentleman, so that there is a possibility that this cyst might have given away 2 days before only. So as I said, you have to assess the patient clinically. If the patient is symptomatic, if he has an ongoing pain, if he has a leukocytosis, he is running fever, definitely I will go and dilate it. The important thing we should remember, the opening is in the first part of the duodenum, the gastroduodenal artery goes across. So if you patient doesn't require and you keep on dilating, you keep on fiddling with the patient, sometimes these patients even in the natural course may present with the massive GI bleed because it erodes the gastroduodenal artery. So my take home message is it will depend upon the patient's symptomatology. If the patient is symptomatic, yes, I will do all the things, do a single time aspiration or may do the dilatation of the pancreatic opening or may do a redo procedures by myself by putting the plastic or the metal stent. And if the patient is asymptomatic, it is better to wait for some time and let's take the nature call. If patient is symptomatic, yes, what you are saying is absolutely right. We can dilate it and we can proceed.
Perhaps we have to clarify, we didn't see the orifice and we haven't had a connection of air between the pseudocyst and the bulb of duodenum. If we would have seen the orifice, you are right, we would follow that idea.
Yes.
We only assume that it is like that and it's it looks like...
And sometimes it may be in the colon. In those situations, patient might require a surgical intervention. Now another important thing which I would like to highlight here, like can you see now, earlier I was focusing this cyst cavity from the first part of the duodenum, now my scope is at the just below the OG junction. The important point is from the duodenum the cyst was very near to the duodenal wall, but if you look at here there is a significant pancreatic parenchyma between the this cyst cavity and the stomach wall. So it is always important that while draining there should not be a significant pancreatic parenchyma between your cyst and the stomach or the duodenal wall. Third important point is sometimes these cysts may be visible from the OG junction if they are in the uncinate process of the pancreas and it looks very lucrative to do it, but as you puncture and you start dilating the cyst, give a distance from that and it produces a perforation into the gut lumen. So before doing it is important you should do a complete examination right from the duodenum, evaluate the pancreatic parenchyma, evaluate the origin of the cyst, is it originating from the neck of the pancreas or originating from the uncinate process of the pancreas, because if it originates from the uncinate process of the pancreas you may be able to see from the OG junction as this cyst is visible. Do you agree with this?
Yes. Does the audience agree with us or is there a disagreement and what are the arguments for that?
So, Dr. Puri.
Yes.
Yeah. So, the wall has already given way. We
yes.
have a fistula there.
Yes.
So, dilating that area at this point of time will definitely be with that increased risk of bleeding. If for some reason we decide to provide symptomatic relief to the patient, I think single time aspiration would be better compared to dilating an area which is inflamed, because normally when you do a pseudocyst drainage you ensure that the wall has well formed. only then you intervene.
So Praveer, I agree with you, but if you look at the CT image, the cyst wall was absolutely well matured, it was encapsulated. Now because the cyst has given away and the air has gone, that's why the cyst wall looks saggy. Otherwise I agree with you, it will depend upon the clinical scenario. A single time aspiration is perfectly fine, but majority of the time when the patient has a symptomatic, if he has a fever, he has a leukocytosis, one time aspiration is not going to give the answer. In those situations, either dilate the natural orifice or redo, you do with an endoscopic ultrasound, do a complete drainage procedure. That will be a better thing rather than just doing the single time aspiration. So it will depend upon the clinical scenario. The most important point, if you look at here Praveer, here the cyst, this is the significant pancreatic parenchyma. Can you see here? There is a significant pancreatic parenchyma, and sometimes the cyst in the uncinate process of the pancreas, they appears here. And if you try doing from here, number one, it is very difficult. Don't do it, because it not only produces the chances of failure of the procedure, patient may land up into the severe pancreatitis, and the failure of the procedure and that this cyst will, because the cyst will collapse and it is in the uncinate process of the pancreas and it will give away into the peritoneal cavity.
Yeah. The topography is very the bulk important of duodenum and not to the stomach wall, because pancreatic tissue is in between. So that was very nicely explained. And it's a collapsing cyst, pseudocyst.
So in that, the cyst which was shown on the CT is around, I think, at the 8 cm. And if we measure it here, can we measure it here? What is the size of the cyst from here?
If enter.
Yes, enter. And is here how much?
4 cm.
Dr. Puri, when was the CT scan done?
The CT scan was a long back, Praveer. I think it was done in the February. Yeah. So I think because the patient is afebrile now, he had pain abdomen, and there is a possibility that the cyst has gone into the duodenum and that was the cause of his pain abdomen. And we just have to wait. He is not running fever. His counts are, I think, 6,700. So better take home message at this point of the time is to wait. But I agree with your idea, putting a needle, taking the sample for the culture sensitivity may be an alternative, but it may not be the hard and fast.
Honestly, I don't see any use for a single pass.
Yeah, I think so. I agree.
I wouldn't treat anything which is not
symptomatic.
If there is no fever and if there is not that symptomatic.
And we can see the dirty material is still coming out from the duodenum as we are
so
taking the score.
He should walk around. He should move. He should raise.
But do you really think by changing the position does it change?
Yeah.
Or in day-to-day routine practice, you are sleeping, you are sitting, you are walking.
Yeah.
That change the natural position.
Yes. So
or do you advise somebody to?
Even when we started at the end of the 90s to do pseudocyst drainage, we have been, let's say, performing X-ray studies to see how that has been the very first one-step puncture of pseudocyst, and we saw how that material is better draining in different positions. So at the beginning we were recommending that the patients are within their bed, nothing happens. But if they walk around and if they move and if they, how to say, change their position, so that natural orifice will work. So that's
now
the
can you see here? Can somebody see here? Can you see
that? It's nice, yeah.
Can you see the beaking of the cyst into the duodenum wall? Here?
Yes.
So probably I think this has... Can you see here now?
Not convincing, but still.
Not convincing.
Yeah,
yes.
But the most likely this should be the duodenum wall at the particular area is thickened. Because if it is because of the pancreatitis, the entire duodenal wall should have thickened.
Yeah.
Why I localize the duodenal bulb is thickened.
In the audience, can you see the endoscopic image? Because this is most important to see that swelling and to see that counterpart, that endoscopic counterpart, which is part of our interpretation here.
Can you see the endoscopy?
Yes, we can see the bulge, the whitis.
Can somebody give the water? Let me clean the lens.
Is there any of the assistants giving some water, please?
Is the air is blocked? Now, can you see the duodenal wall?
Yes. The dimple is the opening. The depression in the center is the opening of the pseudocyst.
Yeah.
We don't believe that we can really identify. There might be 10 of those holes to be seen. We didn't see anything like that.
Can you see here? We don't see the because sometimes the opening is big enough. As you inflate the air, you can see the track. The air is tracking from the duodenal wall into the cyst cavity. That we try to do it.
You are not draining.
No, we are not draining.
So we will have to then decide and come out. Okay. You are willing to?
Patient will be instructed to stand on his head.
Okay.
3 times a day.
Okay.
No spontaneous rupture. He should move, and that's fine.
Okay, so we'll remove the scope and then.
But my feeling is, can you see here? Can you observe this? This is giving. Yeah. Yes, please. Can you see here? Can you see the air? Can you observe the air now?
Yes.
Can you see now?
There's some continuity with the cyst.
No, it's very difficult to say. But this is the outside the duodenal wall.
Oh, right on here.
Yeah. Can you see here? And this is the outside the duodenal wall.
That's nice.
But that is on both the sides.
Yes. Can you see here?
So we would be temporarily shifting to shift to another
see
room
here?
Where decision is pending. We would be showing a duodenal submucosal lesion.
So I think we should change it. They have changed the room.